Hi, this is Rafał from Cumulus, and I have to admit that this is the 12th of February and it is actually the first time we are camping this year. But this camping spot is wonderful, it's awesome, look at this. Because Cumulus is from Gdynia, I guess we have got some kind of partiality, at least I have got some kind of partiality for the seashore landscape. We are even luckier because this camping spot, which is behind me, this is actually a legal camping spot. Can you imagine that? So I guess we can't even wish for more. A warm coffee, a nice sunset here, and the sound of the waves. This is everything we need. Today we have got a short video for you, and the topic being comforters, how to. Alright, so our camp for today is set now. Let me introduce you to the comforters themselves. Comforters have been in our offer for years now and they turned out to be quite popular, to be honest. We can imagine that they are bought mostly by experienced users who are looking for an alternative for a typical mummy-shaped sleeping bags. Comforters are an ideal solution for the trips where you combine nights spent on yachts, campers or trains, or even in a hostels where blankets are not provided, with sleeping in the tent higher in the mountains for instance. What is better than you ask? Our comforters or quilts, which could be opened flat as well? What are differences between those? First of all, quilts are tempered in the foot box and they have got different mattress attachment system. Comforters are square and thanks to that more roomy. Because of the lack of the zipper and heavy attachment system which is used in quilts, comforters are lighter and smaller after compression. The materials used, and I mean the lighter tori fabric which is used in the comforter design, make this weight difference even bigger. Simply, quilts are meant to be used as quilts and very rarely as blankets. Comforters, however, are meant to be used as blankets and can only be used as a sleeping bag in emergency situations. You need to take that under consideration when choosing between those two products. Okay, let's not waste more time and dive in the construction and materials used to produce comforters. First and foremost, we have got three different models of comforters. I can tell you that one more is coming, but this is the secret for now. We have got the M size with 400 grams of down, the L size where 500 grams of down is used, and the extra large size with 700 grams of down. They are 210 centimeters by 120 centimeters, 227 centimeters by 140 centimeters, and 227 centimeters by 210 centimeters, respectively. We have got our own comforter 700, the extra large size. We use it as a double sleeping bag with my wife, and we have got the medium size comforter with 400 grams of down just for the presentation purpose. comforters are made of Torai fabric, which is 7 denier fabric, weighing 19 grams per square meter. They are filled with 850 fill power, ethically sourced Polish goose down. The construction is fairly simple. This is a rectangular shaped product with simple H-shaped down chamber design. Along longer sides, there are small loops to be used for mattress attachment. Shorter sides are equipped with drawstring, which can be used for closing the comforter to avoid cold air drafts during the sleep. And this is basically it. Simple, right? Because of the simplicity in the design, comforters are super versatile and multi-purpose products. Both ultralight fabrics used and simple construction ensure that comforters are extremely light and small after compression. Now, how to use them? Along with comforter itself, you will receive the big mesh bag as well. And just quick note here. Always store down products in big storage bags, never compressed. Down sleeping bags and other down products should be compressed only when necessary and for the shortest period of time possible with the use of small compression bag, which is also provided. Last but not least, in the parcel you will find a set of long shock cord and a few plastic cord locks. There is around 8 meters of shock cord, which you can cut into parts as you wish. The beauty of comforter is that there is no particular way of usage. You can set it up as you want. Here is my way of attaching comforter medium size 400, which I would like to recommend to you. After that, I will present you how to deal with the extra large size comforter. So let's go. We have got the medium size comforter here, my mattress, and I have already cut my shock cord into some short pieces and 3 long pieces. The length of those depend on the mattress you use, and I always melt every end of every single piece of shock cord just to prevent it from frying. Firstly, what I like to do is to close the foot box, to do so I use the drawstring provided here, like that, it is closed, and now what I like to do is to use all of the loops provided. My idea is to use short piece of shock cord and connect every second pair of those small loops. So I start from the foot box with the first pair, I connect those, creating a small loop using the shock cord, like that. I leave the second pair of loops and connect the third. Like that. And I make the same thing with every second pair of loops. Once it is finished, I start to use long pieces of shock cord and connect pairs of loops which are left. As you have seen, I created a simple loop with this short piece of shock cord to connect loops from comforters, but here I tie every end of this long piece of shock cord directly to the loop from comforter. The first one and the second end of shock cord I'm tying to the second loop, the opposite loop from comforter, like that. Let's connect the comforter to the mattress using those long loops now. What I like to do is to grab the loop, cross it, and put it over the mattress, like so. What it does, it pulls on the sides of comforter under the sleeper. All you have to do now is to connect the plastic stopper, like that. And if you would like to extra secure the plastic stopper, you can create a very simple knot at the end of the loop. Once everything is ready, I adjust the length of the long loops using those plastic cord locks. Depends on how tight I would like the comforter to be. And I always leave the very top loop loose because I will adjust it after sliding inside. Let's do this. At the very first glance, the lack of the zipper could look like a problem, but actually, because the Toray fabric is very slippery, it is super easy to slide inside. I need to be very careful with my microphone here, but if I would like to, I can adjust this very top loop as well. And if I would like to have some extra protection, I can also adjust the draw cord here in this top neck area. Now let's move on to the extra large size comforter. The process of shock cord division is nearly the same, but we have to take under consideration that we are dealing with two mattresses now. So the lengths of the short and long pieces of shock cord, those need to be a little bit different, but you need to adjust those lengths depend on the mattresses you use. As we did with medium-sized comforter, I like to close the foot box and use all the loops provided. And as we did again with medium-sized comforter, we connect every second pair of loops with a short piece of shock cord. However, the difference is that I like to connect only one end of the long piece of shock cord and attach the comforter to the mattress, and at the end connect the second end to the second loop from the comforter. Let's connect the extra large comforter to those two mattresses system. We have got two sides of comforter with the long piece of shock cord connected. And what I like to do is to squeeze the shock cord through the gap between the mattresses. Follow along up to the other side, again down and through the gap. And now I connect the end to the loop. And this is the final construction, as you can see. Again, we have got the situation that those sides of comforter are pulled on under the sleeper. Again, at the end, we can attach the plastic stopper. And again, as we did with medium-sized comforter, we can secure the plastic stopper, creating a knot at the end of the loop. Now we can adjust the length of the loop, depends on how tight we want the extra large comforter to be. Easy as that. If you would like to use the comforter as a quilt, it is even easier. All you need to do is to close the foot box, either with medium or extra large size of comforter, tie all the loops around the feet using the short pieces of shock cord, and secure the torso area of the comforter with long pieces of shock cord. You can even leave big loops and get the quilt closed around the feet but open on the top. Last but not least is a way of using the comforter as a blanket. No need for shock cord here, just cover yourself with the open comforter. Simple as that. That was our short wrap-up of how to use the comforter. As you can see, it is very easy, and once you have got your shock cord pre-cut, prepared and tight, it is very fast and intuitive. I recommend you to prepare and test everything at home before leaving in the field. If you have got any further questions about comforters or any other Cumulus products, do not hesitate to contact us via info@cumulus.pl. And now, I have got a nice bonus for you. You have seen those straps to connect two mattresses together, right? Let's make a set of those. Using the magic of cinematography, back to the workshop in 3, 2, 1. Great. Come closer and have a look. You need 4 slim profile clasp buckles like those and around 6 to 7 meters of thin webbing. That of course depends on the mattresses you use, but in case of our very popular Neor X-Lite mattresses, we need around 6 to 7 meters. And the best is the gross grain ribbon here. You can either use 20 millimeters or 25 millimeters version, but then you need to remember to match the buckle's width to the webbing width. Now we need to cut the webbing into 4 same length pieces. In our case, we need around 160 centimeters to 170 centimeters for our X-Lite mattresses, but this length depends again on the mattresses you use. Now, all we have to do is to sew the webbing with the buckles. See how I hide the end of the webbing inside while making a small loop here? We have to sew together our parts into pairs now. Exactly like that. Focus on the buckles facing opposite directions. Having those line up, around 10 centimeters from the buckles, I made a double stitching. Repeat with the second pair. Thank you. And now it is done and ready to be used with your mattresses. So let's move to the field again in 3, 2, 1. Quickly, let's see how those straps work. I lay those flat with buckles facing up. Now, I align two mattresses, one on this side, second on this side, and I just use the buckle and lock the webbing in it. First, second, third, and last one, like so. All you need to do is just put the end of the webbing through the hole in the buckle and close it. Now we have got two mattresses connected. And this is everything from me today. I hope you have learned something new today. Thank you for your time. That was Rafał signing off.